Hey, welcome back to Twinkle Tunes and Lighting. Today we're talking about controllers. What's your favorite controller? I'll tell you what my favorite controller is. Stick around, it's coming up. This is gonna be awesome. Simply put, an LED controller takes information from your show computer, which could be xLights, could be a Falcon player, could be your Raspberry Pi, and that sends information to your controller. Your controller deciphers the information and sends it out to your pixels. The controller is one of the brains of the operation here. And there's several of them out there on the market. There's a ton of controllers. Which one do you pick? Which one's gonna be your favorite? Which one are you gonna kinda gravitate towards? It is a key part of what makes these props, makes these lights work. Let's figure out what kind of controller you need. What kind of controller do you want? I'll tell you the controller I use. It's awesome. Without your controller, your pixels are just pixels. It's no fun. Go get a controller. Let's start with the basics. You have a pixel tester and a basic controller. Great for static props or like first time builds. It's simple, low output, it's budget friendly. A controller that's very simple, very basic would be the Kulp Pocket Beagle controller. The standard pixel controller, this is the most common for everyone. It handles between 4 and 16 ports, and it's ideal for multiple props. Examples of this controller would be the Falcon F16 version 4, the Kulp K8-B, or the K16A-B. So each one of these have several ports. Now, what is a port? A port is basically a plug that you're putting your pixels. It's outputting data out of this pixel port to your lights. Okay, so you are using one port and it controls a certain amount of lights. Okay, the controller controls the different outputs. So you decide, output one could be props, output two could be a snowflake, output three could be a singing prop, output four, you get the picture, okay? So again, what's your design? How do you wanna do this? Now, let's talk about my favorite controller that I use. It's a very niche controller and it's very simple and easy to use. It's the Bong69 controller. Cool name, cool guy that built it, and I own a dozen of these controllers and they're all over my yards. Never had a problem with them, but they're all smart controllers. They're Ethernet based, they're Wi-Fi based, all the outputs are already fused. The input takes either 5 volt, 12 volt, or 24 volt, and it's just an all-around just workhorse of a controller. This is what I own. I own lots of them. This is what I would buy. It's compatible with WLED. If you don't know what WLED is, go check that out. It's amazing open source lighting program. It's compatible with that and it's compatible with xLights. So it can do everything. So on the off seasons and I'm not running xLights, I'm not running a Falcon player, this is a standalone workhorse. I control it with an app on my phone and it works wonderfully. It's efficient and it's affordable and it's great and it's high quality. It's all those things, okay? Go out and grab one. Let's pick the right controller for us. Let's pick what's gonna happen and how we're gonna do this, okay? Number one, start small. Pick a controller based on your prop size and pixel count. Do you need a giant Falcon 24 port ginormous thing with all these and you're gonna make one snowflake? You don't. Eventually you will, okay? And if you do wanna buy that and then, you know, just have one cable hanging out, it's up to you, okay? Start small. If you want to start small, look at the Bong69. Look at the smaller controllers that just do like 4 props or 4 outputs, okay? Look at something like that. Make sure you plan ahead. If you buy a controller, Can you expand it? Do they make more of the same controllers? I bought a Bong69 and then I bought another one. And then I bought two more of them. And then I bought eight more of them. I've got dozens of them. They're always expandable. They talk to each other. They sync to each other. That's what you want to look for. And I would kind of stick to the same make and model. If you're going Falcon, stay Falcon the whole way. Those guys are great. If you're gonna go with Bong69, stick with that the whole way. If you're gonna go with another product, just stick with the same product the whole way. Can you interchange them? You sure can. Is it easy to kind of hook up to the computer? You can, but I know that if I have a controller go down, I've got all the pieces to fix it, or I can swap it out with another controller, reprogram the IP address, and I'm right back up in a couple minutes. Okay, stick with the same manufacturer. Distance matters, okay? Where's your props? Are they a mile down the street? Are they at the end of your driveway? Do you have a giant yard? Are you in an apartment complex that has an HOA and you only decorate one tree? It's up to you, figure that out. Do you need something that's gonna reach those distances? Okay, plan it out, look it out. Make multiple controllers in your yard, okay? How do you wanna design it? Once again, it's up to you how you wanna do this. And then it's your comfort zone. Do you like the DIY stuff? Then go for the Bong69 one. Go in there and you can tinker with it and you can design it and you can make it exactly how you want to. If you just want one that's all the way done and it's a plug and play, then go with another manufacturer. Go with the Falcon. Those guys are great. There's no wrong answer here. It's what you want to do. I like to tinker. I like a good science fair project. So that's why the direction I went. So I could mess around with WLED, make cool things, do whatever I want to with it, okay? If you're gonna stick right to props and stick to holidays, then maybe go a different direction. Controllers are the brain of your system. With the right one, you can bring it to life. Get into design, find your controller, get very familiar with your controller, so that's one less thing that you have to worry about how to troubleshoot or how to program or how to fix it. Don't be scared. They're not that expensive. Jump into a small one, experiment, make it happen, build from there. Now you've got your lights, you've got your power, you've got your controller. Next up, we've got cables, connectors, and safety, okay? Like and subscribe. Thanks so much for watching. Thanks for hanging out. Thanks for being a part of this community. Hit the bell icon, hit the subscribe icon. We'll see you on the next one.